Mike Wilmer.
Right, this is LP, it's Bang Radio. Today I'm joined by the man himself, Future. How you doing, sir?
LPZ, what's good?
I'm good. How you finding London?
From the hood, we give everybody a nickname, so your name LPZ.
LPZ, I like that.
LPZ.
I've got to keep this now.
Yeah.
How's London feeling to you at the moment?
It feels great. I've been in the studio, I haven't gotten... When I leave these interviews, I'm actually going to try to... You know what I mean? Go shopping a little bit, see what the shopping like around.
It's been a nice day today. This is like the first nice day we've had this year. I'm not even joking. The weather's been terrible.
I heard it was been raining a lot for last month.
It's horrible. Yeah. Roll on the sunshine, that's what I'm thinking.
They heard I was coming.
Right, okay. Let's talk about your single, what you got out at the moment. Push That Dope.
Move That Dope.
Pharrell, Pusha T, Casino's on there. Tell us a little bit about the single itself, about production-wise and stuff.
Production-wise, Mike Will made it. The single-wise, me featuring Pharrell, Pusha T, and Casino.
Because you know what I was going to say with Pharrell as well? Pharrell's back with a bang, is good to say, right?
Yes, sir.
What's it like working with Pharrell?
Skateboard P.
Skateboard P. Yeah. What's it like working with him?
You know, been on the skateboard.
Right.
Tricks and stuff.
You know what I was going to say to you as well? Pharrell made a bit of publicity over here with his hat at the Grammys. He's like big... crazy hat.
Yeah, he had a cool hat.
You gonna put anything on like that? You gonna get your own little swag going with big hats, or is it just a Pharrell?
I'm not for sure, man. When you get Grammys and you start getting big performances and you have that much success, man, you put
on
anything.
You can wear what you want.
Wear what you want.
That's it. Okay, album coming up. Honest.
I'm looking for him to pull some out of his hat. Speaking of that, at any time he just pulls some out of the hat, it's gonna be crazy. He gotta be performing in a bird. Just he pulled a hat off and a bird just fly off his head. That'd be
dope. He's the only one that Pharrell can just make it work, innit?
It'd be dope.
No one would answer.
It'll make the hat make sense
about it. It would. That is true. Tell us about the album coming up. The album's coming up. Got any dates set on it yet?
I haven't had the date set on it, but the album title is Honest. So be on the lookout for that. You know what I'm saying? The first single featuring Pharrell and Pusha T. You dig?
You've done quite a lot of features for your career. You got a few more coming up on the album as well.
Yeah, man, quite a few features on the album, man. Many, many moments that I can be able to look back and say, hey, we did it.
Because you know what I like with your style of music? Like, obviously, your hip-hop vibe and that. You've got, like, your Bugatti, the big tune right there.
Yeah.
And then you go to, like, Real and True with Mr. Hudson and Miley Cyrus. Complete difference in music, which is, like, brave as well, I must say. Yeah. But I like it. But you seem to be like just the only really guy doing that kind of thing. Do you agree?
Versatility, yeah. Man. I love that. I love showcasing my versatility and being broad and my choice of just character, you know.
And have you got more plans to do something like that? Because I heard you would like to also work with Coldplay as well, right?
Of course. I'm going to do new music after this album, you know what I'm saying? I have another album coming. I'm going to drop the Free Bands Gang album. That's my label. Drop the compilation, and after the compilation I'm trying to drop another album towards the end of this year, but who knows, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. We're going to do it one day, one thing at a time, and we're going to take care of this Honest business first.
Because the diversity in your music is crazy. Like, again, back to that, Mr. Hudson, Miley Cyrus, and yourself. It is like three different lanes of music, isn't it, together. And it just works. Even if you're like not a Hudson fan, you might be a Miley Cyrus and yourself fan.
Exactly.
So you're covering a big border of people, right?
You got to.
That's the way it works. Right, okay, so you've worked with loads of people, legends like R. Kelly and Snoop Dogg as well. Was there a point whenever you was working with, like, I don't know, R. Kelly or Snoop Dogg, where you just looked across the room and you was like, right, Snoop Dogg?
Man, Snoop Dogg, you know what I mean? That's Murder Was the Case. That's gin and juice.
That's exactly. And with R.
Man,
R.
That's
Kelly
chronic
as well,
that's chronic with Dre, man. That's monumental, you know what I'm saying?
So does it feel to you as one minute it was like kind of normal, next minute, bang, it was just going crazy?
I pretty much grew into everything, you know what I mean? It took off overnight, but it really didn't. It just like took me a time to gel, but it took time for me to gain success. So once it came, it felt like I was supposed to be here. You know what I'm saying? I always felt like I wasn't out of place.
See, the thing is, like, at the moment, like, you're wanted, everyone loves your music, you're doing your thing. Mm-hmm. What's it like in America? Because obviously you're in a high-profile relationship as well. Over here in the UK, like, they don't give you guys a chance.
Okay.
In America, is it like that? Do they the public leave you alone and like the pub, the newspapers and everything? Do you get a break or are they always?
Oh, so over here you say they don't leave you alone?
Yeah, they don't leave you alone over here. What's it like in America? Are they on your case all the time? Oh, they don't.
No one will leave you alone.
Really? I thought like
once you have a public opinion and you're a superstar or whatever and you're dating another superstar and You know what I mean? It's public business. It's public info. So the things you don't want them to know, you can't let them see because they're gonna have an opinion on it.
Just from this side, I always thought like America was not as on you guys, but obviously
I'm wrong. Yeah, they own you.
What I was gonna say, Sierra did pass.
You tweet something wrong, they're gonna be putting it in the blog.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Sierra did pass through our radio station. I don't know, last year, early part of last year, right? And let me tell you, I do Drive Time Show, and 2.5 years I've been there. I'd never had one day off, right?
Yeah.
This day, it was snow. I got snowed in at home and everything. The one day I didn't go in, Sierra passed through to do an interview.
Yeah.
That's bad luck.
That's bad luck.
And I was hoping that you might be able to hook this back up again for me because there's bad luck on my side.
She coming back. You know what I'm saying? She's working on her album right now, so she'll most definitely be back very soon.
One day, innit? It's just bad luck. But anyway. So I just want to ask you as well, what do you think about, obviously, all like the reality TV stuff with your X Factors, your American Idols in America and stuff? Do you agree with that?
I don't watch it.
You don't watch it?
Nope.
Do you agree with it though anyway? Are you even bothered about it or you just don't really care?
I don't watch it.
Don't watch it. All right. Okay. So, some questions I normally ask just for a bit of fun, just some personality questions. You all right with that?
Okay.
Personality or looks?
Both.
I like that. That's a good answer, I suppose. McDonald's or Burger King?
Whoever cut the chip.
Tupac or B.I.G.?
Both.
Cars or bikes? Oh, what you say, both?
Cars.
Home cooking or takeout?
Home cooking.
Are you a good cook yourself?
Nope, don't want to cook.
Don't want to cook. So right, this you and Sierra are going out. You got a red carpet event. Sierra, you're not liking what she's wearing. Do you tell her and risk it, or do you be like, you look lovely, darling, and leave it like that?
I tell her.
Would you?
She'd tell me.
Would she? I wouldn't tell my girlfriend. She'd kill me.
No, you gotta have your girl. You gotta be like friends. We friends, so you know what I'm saying. When you're best friend, you gotta. If I don't tell you, nobody else gonna tell you. So I make sure I tell you the right answer. She gonna tell me how she feeling. You know what I'm saying? That's what.
Yeah.
We be honest with
you. I'm not gonna lie, my girlfriend does scare me a little bit, that's why. But hey, I'm gonna hold my hands up too.
Okay, cool. I'll take that.
I don't know if you see any of the football over here. One of these teams are my team. Hopefully you pick the right one. Arsenal or Tottenham?
No, I'm not for sure.
Mine was Arsenal anyway, just in case you see them, you know.
Okay.
And I always ask my artists, well, last question. We always have a comparisons over here of Rihanna and Beyonce. Okay, you have to pick one or? Both. Is in music wise.
Sierra.
Yes, you're going to be in the good books. I absolutely love that. Right, okay. So just let everyone who's tuned in, just let them know your Twitters and where they can keep up to date with everything and what you're doing and your movement.
Man, the Honest album on the way, you know what I'm saying? My first single, for real, Pusha T. They joined me on that joint, produced by Mike Will Made It. Move That Dough.
Thanks a lot for joining me today.
Man, thank you.
Enjoy the rest of your time in London. Hopefully the weather stays nice for you.
Absolutely.
Good luck with the album.
Man, thank you so much, bro.
Look forward to hearing it and good luck with the rest of your
career. I can't wait till you hear it, man. It's something special.
It's going to be big. Thanks a lot, sir.
Thank you. Special break. Fish scale in the $2 that I fish tails. Fiberglass, Ferrari leather, and designer shit that I miss bells. Yeah, look at the clues, the J's, the jewels. I'm matching the monkey. From 16 years old, I'm whipping in kitchens, my junkies. Pablo Versace, way before me goes. My dinner plates, no silverware. All you, my e-ho. Toss it like a free throw. House that had the peephole.